The following is a presentation of Muddy River News.
So I hope the this is a very good
I feel this is
level.
This is good.
Do you want headphones or no?
I feel comfy.
I'm good. I haven't used them all week, so I'm good.
I know you're good.
Yeah.
All right.
I know.
Are we? So does this make you feel weird that we're wearing headphones and you're
not? No,
not
at all.
Okay.
It just makes you stand out and just.
Well, it makes me feel weird that you're wearing a suit
blazer.
Jacket and I'm wearing a sweatshirt.
Now that might make me feel uncomfortable that you look that good and I look like a scrub.
I know, Dapper Dan over here.
I normally don't have it here, but. The mayor was in here earlier, and so I just thought,
yeah,
I like it better than just with the open collar.
You look very nice.
Well, thank you. That's very kind of you. And I got my hair cut today,
which was
very nice.
Looks nice.
You look
my haircuts though. See, I was terrible when I was married, and my wife would come home and she'd go, "Do you notice anything?" And I'm like, "Nope." What should I notice? I just got 3 inches cut off of my hair. Oh, and I'm like, sorry, I can't tell.
3 inches, though?
You know solved that problem? Just FYI for the guys out there. Every day,
just lie.
Say, you look amazing. Your hair looks great every day.
What did you do?
Yeah. You could be even just more simple. You know, just, you look great. Your hair looks amazing. Just something different every day.
And I'm just the one that just keeps it real. And I go,
I can't tell a thing.
I'm
sorry, I can't. And so when I get a haircut, you can tell because I probably cut 80% of the hair on my head is gone when it's done. So it's pretty noticeable. I mean, I'm just another notch on the razor from just getting rid of the whole thing.
Yeah,
but you don't need
to. But it looks nice.
Well, thank you. That's nice of you. You know,
I'm just full of compliments. Look, I'm not saying it's the raspberry twisted tea.
It's not.
But
no.
It might be.
No, you're always this nice.
Not always.
Well,
no, not around always.
Here, around us you are.
Yeah, that's because I was just thinking this. So we were talking about Bob being gone, which we'll talk about more later, but...
Oh, yeah, Bob's gone.
I know, right? Like, do we even need him? No, I'm kidding.
Bob, what we've been telling everybody is Bob is on assignment Florida.
In sunny Florida.
Too hot in the hot tub. Jump back, get a hold of myself.
In a hot tub, evidently. Yeah.
Now, for those of you who have just watched us add a little clip of Bob's work from Florida.
Yeah.
You have to be old. Okay, I remember Eddie Murphy putting his toes in the hot tub.
Too hot for the hot tub.
That was Saturday Night Live.
I remember that.
So that's Bob's.
Those are the good old days.
That's who Bob is referencing there.
It was amazing.
I like it. Any Eddie Murphy Saturday Night Live references are always welcome.
But when he sent that, it made me miss him, which is so weird. But our team here is amazing, but... It's like he brings this vibe of.
I want to know what this vibe is.
It's silliness and fun and kind of like, you know, that when you walk in the office that he's going to have something smart to say. If he would have been here for my quote,
I would not
have been able to finish it, you know, whereas you're like, you know what you're doing. You're super professional and on point and you have my whole schedule stacked and everything's awesome and you're still super fun and nice. He's just like, I mean, it just brings a different vibe, you know?
And all are
amazing. Every team member brings a different vibe.
As someone who played sports, there's always the coach who is screaming at you, on point.
Good guy, bad guy?
Good cop, bad cop. And
you're not bad cop.
I think in here it's more like I'm the one who has the entire schedule for the week marked up on the board.
Yeah.
And Bob has like the entire financial plan of Muddy River News scribbled out on a piece of yellow notepad.
Nailed it.
But both work.
Both work.
Well, it takes both to make such a cool, well-balanced, well-rounded team.
Well,
and then you throw in Chuck and you and me and Britt and everybody, and it's like, we're just a badass team. I mean, I really think so. And I'm not patting myself on the back, but
be
the PhD.
You're just being that sweet normal Ash that we know.
Yeah, that we know and love, Frankie. Okay. No, I'm kidding. All right, but we have a lot to talk about.
We have a lot to talk about.
Yeah.
Where do you guys want to start? I mean, there's a lot of...
Let's start with the thing that we probably need to clear up, because I think Brittany and I had a conversation about this, and we may have misled some people just based on a few comments that we made. And that is the street cameras that have been tossed around, talked about. Yeah.
That's going to go before the city council on Monday. It was passed by the police aldermanic committee at its meeting before last Monday's city council meeting.
Okay.
But it was sent to the city council without a recommendation, which basically was, as they said, we're going to let the city council decide this. We're not going to give it. They're like,
yeah,
you guys figure it out. Now, granted, the members of the police aldermanic committee are members of the city council, but they just, for whatever reason, they felt like you guys deal with it. We'll let the whole council deal with it.
That is a non-propaganda, pro-critical thinking approach where they're not trying to push something. They probably want it. There's probably some inner, you know, there's all of the libertarian feels where like, we don't want a lot of Big Brother, but then there's the other part of it where it's like, you know,
it might help.
This technology is really necessary for the community. And I'm not advocating one or the other now. I'm saying there's probably,
there's two sides to every story.
There's probably two sides there. Mm-hmm. So what is your, Ashley, what's your general feel on the cameras?
Oh, I go back and forth because I don't like control. However, I use Amazon, Netflix. So if they want my information, it's out there for the taking.
And I think that is probably what I would tell. There's having listened to the people who came to speak to the police aldermanic committee on Monday night, there were many people who were like, we're not comfortable with this information being available to people.
It's already out there.
The fact is, if you're on your cell phone, if you're buying stuff on Amazon, it's already happening. So the fact is, what is happening on with these cameras, and this is where you and Britt made your one bobble, and when you talked, was that all these cameras do is they take pictures. As your car goes through the intersection of 36th and Broadway, it takes a picture of the back of your car going through the intersection. It's a license plate, and it'll maybe help show the make and model of your car.
Not my long hair.
It's not going to show your hair. It's not going to show you picking a booger out of your nose as you're driving through the intersection. It's not taking any video of you to show how fast you are going. It's just taking a picture. Then that goes into a database, which allows the police department to be able to say, hey, we just had a crime happen at this place, and it happened around 4 o'clock, and there was a black Honda SUV that was seen at this. Okay, we're going to go through all the Honda SUVs.
Yeah.
And then if there's one that's been, you know, reported stolen, if there's one that we go, oh, well, we also know who the subject is, and there's a black Honda SUV registered to that person, let's go find that car.
Right.
That's what it is to be used for.
It's not Big Brother.
You're not going to get caught for speeding. You're not going to get caught for blowing a stop sign. You're not going to get caught doing something wrong.
Right.
On it is literally going to take a picture of the back of your car. And many of the things that people have talked about are things that haven't happened in other cities where this technology is available. Or if it does happen, as in, you know what, we've decided that we really want those speed cameras and we're going to sub out that license plate reader, and we're going to put in a camera that catches how fast you're going. You can, the city, all they would be devoted to a 2-year contract.
Right.
And if they think they're too expensive, if they don't think they're working, they drop the contract. They're not stuck with a bunch of cameras and not knowing what to do with them.
Sure.
And so to the people who are worried about, is this in the cloud? What if somebody, you know, if there's some sort of data breach, I understand the concern, but show me somewhere where it's happened and you can't. Not yet. That's not been shown.
I think most of the people who are against it are also against any surveillance, you know, Big Brother type stuff. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to call them conspiracy theorists because I find myself in that bubble, and no longer is it called a conspiracy theorist? It's called a recognitionist. Is kind of what it is. So we've recognized that these things have happened in the past. So I'm not saying that these concerns are not outlandish. It's just another one of my favorite sayings, which my mom passed down to me, is don't borrow trouble. So let's give it a chance. Maybe it would help. And in light of recent crimes, maybe
I think that's what, it's not going to solve any of the past crimes.
Sure, I know.
But, you know, right. How can you look at someone who they lost their car, their house has been burglarized, or worse than that, and then be able to say, well, we thought about getting these cameras, but...
Yeah.
We could have helped you if we got the cameras, but everybody's too worried about the fact that they may sometime in the future, although it hasn't happened yet, be used improperly by a police department member. We're not going to get them.
So this cloud-based, I did a little bit of research. The cloud-based company, also like Netflix is a customer, Hulu is. So if you have a Netflix account, your information is already
absolutely
with this company.
Yeah.
So it's kind of... I hate to, you know, I'm not discounting anybody's concerns. I'll say that.
I don't think we should discount the concerns because I'll push back on it. So I'm not against the cameras for their purpose.
Right. Right.
But it is easy to see that this is a first generation, second, third, or fourth, fifth generation camera. I'm not sure what gen it is, but when you get into 23rd, 24th, 25th generation cameras,
it's scary.
Where they say, you know, we've already got the technology in place. We are going to vote for an upgrade for the cameras. We've had the cameras for 5 years. They've proven, and these are going to, you know, take, you know, they'll be able to see.
Facial recognition.
They'll be able to count the blackheads in your nose. And we are going to do that. But you know what? We've had these cameras for years and years and years, and they've proven to be very valuable to our community.
At
that point, you can vote it down.
Yeah. It is baby steps. It's like, what do you call it? It's eating the elephant one bite at a time.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So
there are valid concerns.
Yeah. For sure. And which, by the way, though, I also want to. So, like I said, I've already prefaced by saying my opinion, if you want mine, is yeah, those cameras are fine. So that's that. Okay. I will say
in
this
their
though,
current state. With the current concept.
There you go.
Push back on the idea that so-and-so is already surveilling you in a terrible way. So we could add more of that.
Yeah.
You know, I'll push back on that.
No, yeah, but I'm not saying that.
I know, but listen, Quincy is trying to use technology to her advantage.
Yeah.
And
Quincy's a girl. I love that.
I mean, I'm super pro women, and it was International Women's Day the other day.
Absolutely.
I know.
A human with a phallic member won the award. Did you hear about that? Yeah.
What?
The person who won the International Women's Day award on International Women's Day is a dude.
Oh, anyway, yeah. That's like a Parks and Rec episode.
Just like the guy who was on the Wheaties backs back in, during the 70s Olympics.
Oh, my gosh.
What's that? That person's name?
I don't know.
It rhymes with, it's Cruce Leonard. What was it?
Bruce Jenner.
That's it.
Oh, okay.
How dare you?
I was like, you are totally setting me up. Yeah.
You just dead named somebody. You're going to get hate mail for
that's
right. Anyway, that person transitioned into
Emily?
A different state. Caitlin.
Caitlin, that's it.
And that person won Woman of the Year.
Yeah,
because the trans movement is anti-female.
Yeah, I know, but hang on,
this is going off the rails?
I was not, you know, we talked about things that we were going to talk about today. Ironically, I was at lunch today with a friend, and this was one of the topics we talked about, but I am not prepared to go.
We'll go right back to shoot camera.
Okay, so hang on just a second. So here's my thing. We all know, Caitlin, that's fine. Number one, New York Times bestsellers are not necessarily best-selling books, but there's an agenda. There is an agenda there.
Mm-hmm.
Everywhere you look, the national female, whatever the heck it's called. Yeah, of course they're going to do that. Because it gets some support. It's also like, you remember when you started smoking was bad for you and restaurants just had to have a non-smoking section?
What a joke.
But the smoke was all around you. It's kind of the same thing. Yeah. It's just like a facade, yeah, almost.
It's all
BS.
It's recognitionism.
Yeah. There you go. Recognitionist. I love it.
See, no, literally, I'd never heard that until you said it. I'm going to use that so much.
Yeah,
now.
But it's.
I like that. Who coined the term?
I don't know. It was on a meeting.
Dude,
I can't.
No.
I can't take responsibility for recognitionist, but it was on a meme. I thought it was so cool. And I was like, yeah, we recognize that there is a lot of bullshit out there. So that's what we call it.
Yeah.
We recognize that there's a pattern. We recognize that, you know, when you have an agenda, it's getting more and more blatant that these things are not necessarily voted on by the general public. It's just kind of this one group that says, yep, this is how we're going to do things.
It's really interesting how technology, I'm going to bring this right back to the street camera thing for a second.
I was just going to say, fact that we've gone from street cameras to transgender people, and it just really was almost seamless.
Club Muddy.
Hey.
It's hot. It's so good. Ah,
yeah.
Ah.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, but no, I will say one thing that's interesting. Did you see the photo I sent you in our text thread about the local fast food restaurant that no longer has servers?
Yes.
No longer has
There's just one? There's more.
They're all over the place.
So like the kiosk thing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So the reason why kiosks are used.
Can you at least wipe them down? That would be real cool.
Yeah. It's interesting. There's been a change in the world. And I think it goes back to the street camera idea, which, by the way, ever go like drive up north up in Chicago and go through the I-pass tollways without an I-pass? You're going to get the street cam shot of your
car. Oh, I've gotten the mail.
This is what we're talking about here.
Yeah.
And you can't see who's driving it. And you can't see me, you know, smoking a doobie with my like legs out the window.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. You can't see any of that. All you see is the
license plate.
You know, they Photoshop my feet out. It makes, you know, you can't see anything except for the make and model.
Right.
The license plate. But this whole idea of technology changing the way that we do things.
Mm-hmm. 100%.
And by the way, you can see in every topic from immigration, the technology can be a wall. You see it with reproductive rights where you have technology. Okay.
Yeah.
Technology changes.
It's even talking about it via technology that makes it such a big damn deal.
So back to kiosks and these street cams where I walked into this local restaurant, a fast food restaurant in Quincy. It's been there for a long time. And I don't mind saying the name of the restaurant, but it doesn't matter.
They all are going that direction.
The point is I walked in and I was surprised to not see anybody, really any humans around.
Yeah.
It's just kiosks and you order it. And there's people in the back cooking.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And
for now
you sit down and they call your name or number and you go up and you pick it up. They don't even pay for a food runner to run it out to your, because a food runner is more labor and they've got to like take their gloves off and go wash your hands again. It's too much work and you get your own soda. I mean, it used to be where all of these fast food restaurants would hand you the soda, but now most fast food restaurants send you to the soda fountain kiosk where you do it. Everything's getting automated.
Everything is self-service. Customer service is out the window.
Tech driven to do the same job or find either not cutting corners so much, but like with the street cams, it's do we want to hire more humans?
That is really what it comes down to.
Humans call in sick.
Fallible.
They get sick.
We're fallible.
They're heirs. They cost more money.
Mm-hmm. They need generally insurance.
They're harder to train.
It's
all of it.
If you can, if our police, if we want,
it's
if
really
we,
scary.
If we really do back the police,
mm-hmm.
we really do talk about how we support the police in our community. Then, if they're saying, you know, we don't have the budget to do everything that we want to do, we're probably short a number of officers. I don't know how many they say.
Right now, they're around 10.
They're short 10?
They're short 10.
And they're saying, can we use the technology at our disposal to make the community safer?
Yeah.
And then you got the tinfoil hat wearers, which I don't believe they even exist anymore, but goes back to your point. You know what? Let's cross that bridge when we get to it.
When that happens, then let's talk about it. It hasn't happened.
Right.
Yeah. So don't, I don't want
don't
to
fret
see
about
the
tomorrow's troubles.
Thank you. Thank you, Mom.
Yeah,
that's
my mom.
That was your mom.
Yeah.
And it, you know, I look at what you were talking about with the kiosks and all, you know, what is the phrase, you know, work smarter, not harder?
Yeah.
The fact is, I'm very capable of going Big Mac, order fries, large Coke, card.
Hey,
how tough
question,
is it?
Question for you though. Prices of those Big Macs are going up. They are paying less people. You are working for that company. Are you still okay with it?
Well, I think one of the reasons why prices are going up is because the minimum wage is going up.
Yeah, but you're now working for them. They have cut their staff.
No, sorry, that's not working for me.
But
just saying. I mean, okay, but I can go two tacos and a Diet Coke.
Sure.
And it's, to me, that's not
working. I have a different view, and it does go with another meme I've seen. And it's like, listen, it's not really a meme, but it's like a story. Like, go to Walmart, self-checkout, okay? You're checking yourself out. Mm-hmm. Then you pass by the lady who wants to check your receipt and make sure you didn't steal anything. It's like, I mean, you either trust me or you don't. You want me to do the job of checking myself out, which is, they ate the elephant one bite at a time too, mm-hmm. there, because now it's like they have two lanes open. You're responsible for doing this. Now they're double checking, and I get it. It is the way of the future. It doesn't mean we have to all be okay with it. I'm definitely not okay with going into McDonald's, paying twice the amount that I paid when they had double the amount of workers, the overhead, and still getting the wrong food. It's like, okay, I'll just cook my own damn cheeseburger. And that's just my overarching feel.
I think the from a comedic standpoint, you're hitting the nail on the head, you know, from like, the oh my gosh, you know, good point.
Yeah.
Also, without seeing their P&L, without seeing their financial statements, I don't know what the property taxes have increased on Broadway. I don't know what insurance costs. So when I look at our insurance costs, since the supply chain has been on fire and since the lockdowns, because we don't talk about COVID, we talk about the lockdowns.
Pandemic.
Yeah. So when you take a look at all the increased costs, when you're shaving off some of the labor controls and adding in some of the tech, I still think it is a little bit tougher to make a dollar right now. I really do. Also, these big box stores that you're talking about, they're getting, can I say ass on television?
I mean, I do.
I've heard way worse. I've heard way worse.
Those big box stores are getting their asses kicked.
Yeah.
So what's happening is the tech of Amazon, the high tech, the high capital increase, the high capital outlays, the taxes, the insurance rates, the minimum wage, all of the stuff that it takes to make a normal operation that is what
without
it is.
Tax shelter.
I'm saying, like these big box stores that you're talking about, where you go in. Mm-hmm. I mean, they're going to be the way the dodo bird at some point in time.
You think
Well,
they have such tax shelters like Amazon. I mean, these big corporations.
I'm talking about the big box stores. You're talking about how when
big
you
box
are
stores big corporations.
I'm talking about
right?
when you go to the grocery store or you go to the Walmarts. The
I try to steer clear of Walmart.
The big box store. You're talking about these places where you go in and you're doing this work.
Yeah.
I'm saying that it's possible, which by the way, from a comedic standpoint, what you've got is gold. Yeah. I don't disagree with you. Yeah. I'm on your side.
Sure.
I'm just saying like the insurance, my insurance has doubled in like the past four years for all, like, I don't have that, you know, just for certain properties and certain things like that. Stuff is getting more expensive. Everything's getting more and more expensive and the value of the US dollar is going down. And as when you're running those businesses, you cut two or three, four or five employees to have your kiosks that costs tens of thousands of dollars.
Yeah.
And then plus the maintenance, the upkeep. And at night, the IT team comes in and you're paying them out overtime to go in and fix and upgrade the software on the kiosks.
Yeah.
I'm saying you're right. You're making me do this and now you're checking me.
That's from a consumer standpoint. Now also from a hiring standpoint, because I see both sides, but it's almost like you have to question, okay, are robots, you know, is automation the end goal or is it chicken or the egg? We can't find people to work. So we're placing this and how did the problem of not being able to find people to fill these roles, create the need for automation or was automation the end goal the entire time? And I think if you look at it a couple different ways, so I'm reading this book by James Patterson called The Store. I don't know when it was written. This book basically lays out what I envision the future to be like. And I think The Store is basically Amazon in a nutshell. in the future, what it kind of says is there will be entire communities that are, they know what you want before you know it. So they move you into this community, you open your cupboard and they have all your favorite brands. They have every, but there's something freaky about it, right? So that would be my question. Is automation the end goal, or are we placing automation to help shortcoming? You know, it, does that
maybe
make sense?
Maybe
make
there's not a goal. Maybe there's not a conscious goal.
Don't think so.
Maybe not. Maybe
I'm
not.
So agenda driven. Everything has an agenda to me.
You know, there's definite agendas. It would be silly for me to say there's no agendas. We're just flying by the seat of our pants. There's some truth to that. There's a lot of gray here. Have you ever heard of Amazon Go?
Yes.
I've heard of it.
Okay.
Yes.
But I don't know much about it.
I will give the very short description of it.
Okay.
Amazon Go is a grocery store. Okay. I went to one in Seattle. On the block, I have a friend. Shout out to Zlatko. They used to live here in Quincy. Now it lives elsewhere. Living in Seattle. He goes, "You want to see something crazy?" I'm like, "Yeah." So we go to Amazon Go. Here's what Amazon Go is. You set up an account on your
phone. It's a brick and
mortar? It's a brick and mortar.
Oh, I thought it was online. Okay. Keep going. I'm learning something.
Amazon Go. Okay. You walk into a brick and mortar. You walk into a grocery store. Grocery store looks like Whole Foods with a little makeover. So maybe like
fancy.
Just clean, bougie, minimalist. All the fruit looks a little bit, it looks fake. It's just perfect. They only sell, this is Amazon's flagship pilot store.
Okay.
You walk into the store. Everything looks kind of normal, but kind of like Stepford Wife.
Yeah.
But then when you look up, there are thousands and thousands of little black cameras, dots that look like spider eyes.
Yeah, cameras.
And what you do, there's no money exchange. You have an app. Before you walk in the store, you open your app. You put the phone back in your pocket. You can walk over stealthily in your pocket. You can take a piece of gum and stick it in your pocket. You can try to trick the cameras and kind of move over, do sleight of hand. You walk out the store. He's like, "Watch this." He's like, just grab stuff and put it in your pocket. I'm like, okay.
What if
I guess we're
grape,
getting arrested together.
What if you eat a grape right there? Like I've been known to do that.
It sees it. It knows it.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
There is a particular kind of technology, and I encourage everybody to Google Amazon Go and look at the videos.
Yeah.
YouTube this stuff. See? Take a look at it. What happens? You walk out. You don't go through checkout. You just walk out the door. And then you get a notification that lists all the things that you have and how much your account
has
been deducted.
It's like the toll pass. They know.
They know.
See, the store, there were drones that followed you everywhere.
So
I'm like, ugh.
People who are against
the cameras
mm-hmm. have a point.
They've read the store.
They've been reading John Patterson.
I'm telling you, man.
And it's just interesting where we're going. Stuff's happening. Technology is advancing. Humanity is progressing.
Are we?
That's what they say. I don't even know if... My version of progress, David, is different than other people's.
Absolutely.
I feel like we're getting more reliant on automation. I mean, a cell phone. You don't even need to do math anymore. I think we're relying on that. What do you think?
I agree with that. But I also think that when... Do I need to have somebody help me go to the store and check out my bananas, go get the can of deodorant? You know, if the technology exists to eliminate that person, I think what it also does is it basically tells these people, we have to do a better job of educating our own.
Mm-hmm.
So they're better prepared to go, I don't need to be the person who stocks that shelf. Instead, I'm going to be the person who's working on the cameras that help get who work with the automation. Mm-hmm. Do I think automation is necessary in all facets of our business? No, because I'm hearing about the AI software that will write your term papers for you. And my thought is,
crap.
Really? No, I look at that and I go, really? Is that what you want? You want to be able to learn how to ask a computer to do the work that you should do yourself.
Well, but I don't think it's people saying, do we want that? I think it's just, it's almost like a transformance without even because the younger generation, it's like almost like, oh, this is happening. You better get on board. And us as older people, we're like, oh man, if we don't use ChatGPT, we're like out of the loop here.
This
right?
exactly was happening so a number like of years ago when yeah. you had hashtag learn to code.
See?
It was hashtag, do you remember the hashtag no. learn to code?
I do.
So there was this, so do you know, you've heard, okay, boomer, have you heard that?
Yeah, it's so, like, it's so almost like an insult or something.
So, okay, me being like I don't want to label myself as a Twitter guy, but I read my
you're a Twitter guy.
Well, my
you're not Twitter, a Facebook guy because you're in jail.
I'm out of Facebook jail.
Are
now.
You?
Yeah, oh, I'm out of Facebook jail.
Yeah. All my posts will be placed lower in the news feed until 2026.
I still see them, so that's what's important.
So
2026.
Lower in the news feed. No, I've been in jail. I've been in jail seven times.
What do they call
times.
That? Shadow ban?
Shadow ban.
Yeah, I still see your shit. So they're like, this girl doesn't matter.
Yeah, because they know you're in cahoots. They're like,
oh, yeah.
You might as well show her because she's been getting shown.
Hey, and she hates Walmart. We're going to take her out pretty quick anyway. Like, so
she's
yeah.
a patriot. She's a patriot. Yeah. Get them.
Get them. Yeah. Anyway,
them all
I'm
together.
Sorry. I did not mean to. But anyway,
I was going
to
say so.
Uber, yeah.
Used no. to so the whole thing
go, David.
David so David I don't want I'm not an ageist man but Bob likes to say that he's in Gen X you're in Gen X I'm Gen X you and I are more you're at the end of Xennial
yeah
which is like the cusp of it
I like I'm, to say I'm, the coolest generation
I'm deep
ever.
Into balls deep
yeah
I think Gen X would be definitely not well the boomers are probably the worst generation. Let's be honest. Sorry, Dad. He's so mad at me. You know how Tom Brokaw wrote that book
yes.
called The Greatest Generation?
Absolutely.
My dad wants to write a book called The Worst Generation. It's all about the boomers.
Oh.
Which, by the way, I'm saying, so let's just assume you're like around a Generation X kind of a character and you don't like what the boomers are saying.
Mm-hmm.
And you say, okay, boomer, like sarcastically.
Yeah.
So now what the boomers are doing, they're taking a look at the
like this.
Gen Zs, which are also known as the Zoomer generation.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I've never heard that.
Yeah, because they're all about Zoom.
Like
they're all about the technology. The
Teams and Zoom, yeah.
Technology.
All right.
This podcast is really about technology.
It is.
I think, and how it technology is. Changes us for the worse and for the better.
Do you think we're scared of it because we're old? No. No, I think we're realist. Anyway, go ahead.
It's not.
I think realistic is a better choice.
Because, I think realistic
because
is good.
We've seen both sides, and the Zoomers coming up, they have been conditioned to love it, and I feel like that's kind of where the transformative years, they have been introduced and have been shown the benefits of it, not necessarily the benefits of face-to-face communication.
Don't you think that's the part where they just struggle with terribly?
Gosh, man, if you go to Taco Bell nowadays and you're like, okay, that's not my order. And they're like, well, it is because the screen says it's your order. I'm like, I didn't order that. Well, yeah, it is your order. I'm like, but it's not, bro. You know,
Bruh.
Let me speak in your lingody here. That ain't my order, pal. That's not what I ordered. Like, but yeah, they just don't get it. I'm sorry, I'm not being a dick, but yeah, the customer service is just kind of like gone.
And I think,
it's so
at
sad.
Least in Quincy, Illinois, I think that's where you talked about the fact that customer service has
just almost
disappeared,
yeah.
Which is why certain businesses thrive.
Right.
Because that is their mode of operations.
Yeah.
That's what they do. I
Boutiques.
Believe. I think about what we do here.
Yeah.
Is we write about local things.
Yeah.
We talk about local things, and people are dying for that information. Whether it's from the media or the phone, there's a connection. You want to have a conversation with somebody sometimes, and I think that's what we as the older generation of the Gen Zs, we just want to have a visit. I just like to go to lunch with somebody and talk because I want to know what you think.
Do you think
and
that's
I want
eventually
to know how your
go
life.
Away?
I think there's a lot
of
people.
Do you think Zoomers are going to be like, who wants to? Yes, it is
how
going away.
People,
they don't even like to talk on the phone. They just text.
They just want to stay home.
Ugh.
I have a home. That's where I stay.
Nobody
that's
even
where
goes
I'm
to
comfortable.
Bars anymore.
Is it you that told me the story about your kid went to school and you said, hey, tell little Johnny down the street about the thing going on Friday night, the birthday party. And the kid goes, okay, fine. And then when you get to school, then you come home, he's like, did you tell Johnny? He's like, yeah, I saw him, but like, I'm just going to text him later. Like, well, did you think about telling him?
That's
like,
my kid too.
Like, no, I'm like, why do I have to tell him? I can just text him.
They don't see the importance. I guess they don't see the importance, the benefit, the need to even be communicative, to have interpersonal communication. I think that's, so we can't blame them because that's what's been shoved on them. And especially with kiosks and stuff, that's just going to continue. A lot of times, my kids are a little bit different because we've brought them up around such a huge social circle and with things, and like, it's important. Customer service is important. But a lot of people will be like, oh my God, I never have to talk to another person again in my life. Score. You know, I'm happy with the kiosk. I don't have to deal with the dipshit.
And I think that's where people are going. I think, you know, the fact that the day is going to be coming here in Quincy, Illinois in the not too distant future when you and the wife and kids go, you know what, we're not going out tonight, but I'm not for let's just order a couple of pizzas, and we're going to have the automated drone.
That drone is bringing them in.
Bring
them
to your house. Mm-hmm. But, and you know, you're... Well, I don't got to tip the guy at the door because he wasn't nice to me or whatever. Those days are coming. There's multiple opportunities to get rid of that interpersonal experience.
People love it. You know what? You just,
it's like a good relationship, bad relationship.
We love the drones because we don't have to tip them.
Ew.
Which, by the way, do you know how big the Amazon drones are? So they're as big as SUVs.
Oh my gosh. Okay.
And they can carry a lot of weight, and they themselves are very heavy because they have their own battery technology.
Yeah. And those batteries have to last a long time. So
they do. And like the drone thing is coming, which, by the way, back to technology,
mm-hmm. Yeah.
Curbside delivery is the mother of invention is necessity.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The lockdowns did a really good job
creating
of furthering the curbside delivery, which, by the way, is you do this, you drive your car up. So when it puts it in your cabinet in the back of your car, just like you were saying, coming full circle on that.
Yeah, it is.
It's the same thing.
I know.
Eventually there will probably be people that you're off at work, boom, boom, boom. They do the retinal scan at your front door because only they can get in.
Yeah.
And they do the retinal scan in your front door. They're being videotaped because you've got video cameras all over your house.
Yeah.
And they know not to steal because it's their job.
Yeah.
And they go in and they put all your groceries away.
Yeah.
Which, by the way, that's already happening.
And the fact is,
but that takes away the human
But again,
I think
it comes back to there are people in this world right now who go, that is perfect. I don't have to go to the store.
Yeah.
I don't have to put the groceries away.
Well, and it's growing.
That's
that group
awesome.
Is growing.
And I go, I like going to the store. I like going down the store and seeing,
I like touching,
Frankie, how you doing, man? Good to see you.
Right.
And then I go down to the next aisle. I go, oh, well, there's Ashley over there. I haven't seen Ashley
because you're not a Zoomer.
Yeah.
And I'm just, I enjoy, you know, we could do this podcast from home.
Oh, I don't want to do that.
But I don't think it's the same thing.
The same.
And so to me, I think it's just, if that's what you want to do, great.
I mean, we
knock
all learned that having beers together in your garage while your friends are on Zoom or Teams, it's doable. It's doable.
Which, by the way.
But what a letdown.
Which, by the way, podcasts that are done on Zoom statistically are way less successful than the ones where you see the round table with the video of the people sitting around the table.
Yeah.
There's that organic feel. Mm-hmm. And it goes to this, another aspect of technology and I'm going to drop this in at the very end because we're if our fearless leader was here right now, he would tell us a wrap.
Yeah, but
up,
I'm telling
we're
him
at
to.
The end. But one time that we want to have to talk about the AI. I don't want to say sex bots, but I don't know what that tech is called.
Yeah.
But you know, like, have you seen the deep fakes on video where you see President Biden saying something, like he's saying the craziest stuff, but it's not him. It's the AI.
That's so easy.
It's the robots.
It's so easy.
The ChatGPT is you're asking the AI. We're already talking about the robots. We're talking to the robots. We're teaching all the robots how humans are.
Yeah.
All that, like Elon Musk said, he's like, what we're doing right now is we're teaching the robots how we are. We're funneling it all up in the cloud, and they are taking all the information at light speed and making quick judgment calls. Mm-hmm. on humanity. Yeah. And they will do it better than us. They will do everything better than us. They will laugh better, tell funnier jokes. Mm-hmm. They will be sexier, better. Sex will be better with these robots. Everything is going to be better with the robots. That's what the Zoomers say. But the Boomers and the Gen Xers are saying.
Yeah, until they forget to program that robot, that the humans are not as strong and that robot rips their arm off. That was in a, remember I brought that up? Like you have to, there are so many things, there are so many facets to the human mind and the makeup of anatomy that robots just can't, I don't care how hard you try, you will never be able to recreate what we have, period, the end. And that's the reason that people get nervous, because there is always going to be that one minutia that is forgotten about, and that could ruin everything. So why something that's not broken? Let the humans continue, right? We don't need, I say that, like it's just, this is why I say I go back and forth, because yeah, I'm good. Cameras, fine. If those cameras start like making me sandwiches, I'm gonna freak out.
You know what? It goes back to this. There's been a ton of books and fiction written about this, and a lot of the fiction winds up being nonfiction.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And you know, there's from the political, from the political side, from 1984 to Animal Farm to all of the different funds. You know, Star Trek. You know, they used to say, "Beam me up." Like we're talking into our watches.
Yeah.
A lot of this stuff is happening. But one thing that is interesting is
still don't have flying cars. It is possible. Totally bummed about.
Yeah, that's kind of bum. Yeah, no flying cars.
You're ready for a flying car?
I mean, I think you know we were all ready for something cool. Now we're getting like freaky. I would rather have something cool that takes me above all the other crap than a freaky robot at a store. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know. Like, let's get some good.
When you talk about humans, like. It's not broke, don't fix it.
I mean, we're broken. I go back and forth,
The religiosity of it is original sin. We're super flawed. We're terrible. Yeah. And we need...
That's what makes the world go round.
I know. And then we've got this other part where, you know, the Zoomers are saying, listen, we need all the help we can get. We need to keep on progressing. And like the Gen Xers and the Boomers are saying... Well, that's fine. Jesus is going to come just a little bit faster.
Yeah, so, you know. Right? Because here's my thing. Like, as a human, there's always room for improvement, right? There's always that level, that next level that you can aspire to be to. Well, how does a robot then, if you're looking, this is me talking about robots again. We didn't even say that robots are going to be a thing, but I truly believe that they will be eventually.
Oh, by the way, street camera is the eye of the robot.
Yeah. So then how do you encourage... How do robots get better, I guess? I mean, they are through like AI and stuff, but like, how do they get better? Like with, I don't know, like your conscience, there is not, I don't know. Is there one? I don't know what the limitations.
It's
super scary.
It's kind of
now I'm rambling. Mind can't like.
No, what you're doing is you're pursuing the Socratic method. And part of that, is this idea of like, what is consciousness? You know, I mean, some people think that like ants, have you ever stepped over an anthill and seen how majestic they are?
I never.
Oh my gosh!
Ants or flies or anything.
No, I mean, I'm just saying those ants aren't aware of me.
Yeah.
They don't even know what's going on.
Right.
But they do. They all have a job to do.
They see our large legs and they're like, yeah.
I mean, if you take your finger and stir, they'll all start freaking out. Yeah. Oh, it's awful. But I think what's going to be interesting is how humans evolve, and if we really get ourselves into a terrible mess. But I'll leave.
Oh yeah, we do need to wrap up. I mean, I could sit here and talk to you guys.
As we close up this podcast, and maybe we can continue this at a later date, are the street cams going to help us build society to the point where we can leave this planet and go to Mars? And that is a half joke, but it's-
We're already headed that way anyway.
In the meantime, if it's not that dramatic, maybe we just need to help out the cops and install the street cameras.
Yeah. Now, are there going to be robots on Mars?
Yeah. There's already.
Ro-
yeah. Okay. It's called the Moon Rover.
Oh, yeah. But that's just like a little dog looking thing, right?
No. You should look up Boston Scientific and watch those things. No, you should watch those robot dogs.
No, Boston Scientific reminds me of that damn TI calculator that I had. I'm out on that.
That's Texas Instruments.
But it wasn't it like the same gig? Like they brought in all that crazy technology.
All I'm thinking about is the slope of the tangent line in calculus, and now I'm feeling nauseous.
Anyway, Yeah.
I had a lot of fun with you guys.
I did too.
Thank you.
Sorry for going off on so many tangents.
No, yeah. No, that's okay.
David's like, hold on. He's like, wait a second.
He's like, oh my God, I thought like,
why is Frank talking about sexual?
Like I said, I'm here to just ride the wave.
Yeah.
I'm not here to create the wave. You guys do this every week. So we're not going to, you know, there's no reason for me to sit there and say, no, you have to, you got to roll with me. No. I'm the guest on your show today.
Well, I like the ride the wave. Your new nickname is Cowabunga.
Yeah, nice.
Love it.
And with that,
we're out.
Have a nice day, everybody.
Thank you.
Thanks, everybody.
Bye. Muddy River News. Our home. Our news.